When the shop that I bought all my steam engines from decided it was going to close down, I went there one last time and sort of scavenged some souvenirs, if you'd like. Namely this turbine and this boiler, both being more or less prototypes. And the mini beam engine you see here, I actually got much earlier, but is still on here because it is in need of a boiler. Back then you had the option buy it with or without a boiler. Without was cheaper, that's what I got. And I thought it would kind of be a neat idea to hook both the turbine and the steam engine up to this boiler and build ourselves a two-way valve so that I can either direct steam into the turbine or the little engine here. Apart from making the valve, we're also going to make a new base. That will be off camera. If you want to see me make a wooden base, then I suggest you look at the tap and die stand video. It's going to be pretty much the same except for the cutouts and drills. What we're also going to do is of course polish the boiler up, maybe even the steam engine. We're going to make ourselves an adapter so that I can hook my propane torch up to this burner here. And what we're probably going to tackle first is we'll get this machine here leak-proof. You see the piston, or the cylinder rather, is aluminium. The valve chest is brass. They're both glued together and the seam has just gotten old over time and is leaking like crazy. So we're going to go in here with an X-Acto knife blade and see if we can break the seal apart, reapply glue, and get this thing nice and tight again. Yeah, and then, as I said before, polish this guy up, maybe optically improve the chimney on this one, and make the two-way valve. Okay, I've got nothing more to say, let's get started. The baseboard is coming along nicely. I've opted for some radius fillets on the sides, and I just wonder why these always turn out better off camera than when I actually film it. Oh yeah, right. In case you're wondering what the hell did he do with his hands and who did he slaughter, I'm just currently varnishing the wood here with mahogany, and it just happens to look a bit like blood. I would never slaughter anybody on camera. Or would I? We'll also need to make a sort of bracket in order to keep the turbine in place, and in order to catch the condensate running down the exit here, we'll make ourselves a little tray to go around it. You may have noticed I started using a scriber block in order to mark out dimensions on parts. And I have to say, these guys really shine when it comes to hole positions. Say, for example, you have a part like this one here, which needs a row of 10 holes drilled all the same distance away from this edge here. Well, set your distance on this block, scribe the line, and every hole I set onto this line is going to be exactly as far away from this edge as the last one. However, whenever I mark out a contour of a part, that is purely for rough orientation and for the purposes of the video, so you can see what I'm actually intending to do. Because these things are not as accurate as the lines they scribe look. I'm using a ruler to set these dimensions, for crying out loud. That's the sort of accuracy you can expect from this guy. When marking out hole patterns, most often it's not as critical where exactly the hole is, but where the set of holes are relative to each other. Two lines need to be exactly parallel, for example, but it doesn't matter if they are 55 millimeter or 55 and a half apart. That's always in the tolerances, but if they're not exactly parallel, something's going to bind, something's going to misalign. A contour of a part cannot be machined to within, say, a tenth of a millimeter with just a scribed line. This thing, as I said, is just for orientation, so that you don't get confused what side needs what kind of machining done to it, but they are never a substitute for a pair of calipers or even a micrometer. Keep that in mind. So while that is curing and the board magically works on its own, we're going to deal with the valve here. I've got a, well, 3 to 4 piece design, if you wish. You basically have the main body here with a valve that has a cross-drilled hole, and it's going to be turned by a handle, and that's going to move this hole either in this position or in that position. So this here is threaded M3, and so is going to be... And so is going to be the handle on this one. We're probably going to have to counter it with another nut so that we don't just twist the handle in the valve, depending on how tight I make the fit between this inner sleeve and this outer tube part here. Alright, you saw me melt attempt number one there. I then decided to do exactly the same thing but be more careful with a torch next time. Managed to break the milling cutter in process, so yeah, that part is crap. I then decided to use 10mm square and do the same thing. But now this is such a thin part that I'm afraid I'm going to flood everything with solder and have tubes sticking partially into here. So attempt number three this time is going to be from, geez, what this is, 16mm square. Well, I tried to mimic the look of how it would have been originally with the three spigots at the ends, but I'm not really happy with how that looks. And I also really marred the surface here in the four-jaw chuck when turning the spigots. So, sort of a new piece. We're going to try again with a simpler geometric shape this time. I mean, I've got some more material left. We can have a couple of attempts here. Alright, so here's what I've come up with. I did like the looks of the original design better, with the round piece in the middle and the flanges for the tubes on the sides, but this is, you know, the best I can do without significant amounts of effort. And who knows, this thing might be a total failure and that it leaks everywhere, so I don't even know if this is going to work. So this is, you know, what it's going to look like. I figured it's probably going to be a great idea to have a plate soldered onto here so that I can mount this thing to the baseboard and not have all the forces of levering on here taken by this tiny tubing. And that's what we're going to do next. Okay, now for the burner I have this screw-on gas cartridge, and while making a steam valve is okay for me, I think a gas valve is something that I wouldn't be comfortable with. I would have the proper tap for it, but I just figured these guys are so cheap and I think you can value a life for the price of these guys. It's better than having a leak and not knowing where and an open flame right next to it. The only thing we have to do to this is modify the stem here a bit, because I want to run the burner off a silicon tube, and then we can just make ourselves a little adapter in the four jaw and press that into here. Okay, so we're upstairs in the kitchen, sorry for the bad audio, and we're about ready to steam test this thing. You can see I've filled the boiler up right to the brim, and we'll see how it goes. test ran this thing on compressed air off screen, and I have to say I have two concerns. One is that when I ran this, it took 2 bars, not metal bars, but pressure bars, that's a whole lot more PSI for you Imperial folks, to run the turbine just about tick over. And I'm not sure that the safety valve of this boiler isn't going to blow off a lot earlier than that. Plus, I don't think that a boiler this tiny is going to be able to produce that much steam continuously to keep it running. I just think the resistance in the pipes is too big. Now, why didn't I make the pipes larger? Well, the superheater pipe that is used in the boiler is only 2 millimeters inside as well. So, you know, if I made these even larger, there wouldn't be any difference. I've currently set the lever here to the left so that any steam is going to evaporate into the turbine, and we know that we're steamed up. The second concern I have is that this valve may be leaking quite badly. I noticed there was some kind of hissing noise, which I'm not sure either it was, you know, the hose from the compressor into the boiler, or it was the valve, so we'll see about that. If it leaks too badly, we'll have to, you know, make a new one or buy a new one, I don't know yet. I'm okay with a little dribbling and stuff like that, but if there's just fontanes of steam coming out of here, then it'll have to go. Oh, you can already hear the first steam and the first water. Oh no! That might be only condensate. Might be fine with that. Let's shut the steam off and wait for it to build up a little more. This is nowhere near enough for the turbine yet. We'll run the little one here first. Water, and there we go! Hey, nice! I don't even remember how long ago I ran this thing last time. That's awesome! Now you can see a little bit of steam coming from the side of the valve, but that's okay. I'm fine with that. That's no big deal. Okay, I've shut the valve here off for some time, and you can just about see the safety valve blowing a little bit of steam, and I think that's all we can get. You can see the valve has now started to leak with the rising pressure, so we'll see if the turbine is able to spin. No, not at all. Okay. It's just not possible to run the turbine, so it will have to stay as sort of a demo object here. Oh well. After all, at least the tiny machine here is running nicely. Okay, so the boiler is pretty much empty now. Pulled the burner. Little disappointment on the turbine, I'll be honest. But seriously, I'm happy with how it is. I mean, you would need a way larger burner and boiler and tubing for this turbine, I think. And what would it do? It would just make noise and run a little bit. It's not driving anything. Turbines have very little power in these model steam size ranges, so it would be kind of pointless anyway. You wouldn't see anything, that's the main point. I mean, seriously, that would be the most exciting thing that would happen. So, I think I'm keeping this just the way it is. I mean, it looks nice as an ensemble. I'm probably not going to run it that often anyway. And we'll see how long the glue will last here. If it doesn't, well, then we'll have to come up with something else. Maybe make the cylinder out of brass as well. But I won't do anything of that sort until I can be sure that it's really going to break down. So yeah, what do you think? Let me know in the comments. I'm happy with it. Certainly looks a lot better than it did before. And you know what I'm happiest about? What I did actually is this ridge around the chimney here. I think that just makes the entire boiler look so much nicer. When the pipe is just straight, it just looks kind of crude and odd. So yeah, that's that. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. And see you all next time. Bye!